I stand here on behalf of a grateful government and the people of Fiji. We are gathered here this morning to honor the life of the Late Ratu Tevita Momoedonu. The sheer number of people here in UCC village is testament to the scale of Ratu Tevita's contribution to our nation. I know the pain of passing is great, but I hope his wife, Mrs. Kolora Momoedonu, his children, his grandchildren, and his great-grandchildren, and the rest of his family and his friends, take some comfort from the fact that Ratu Tevita was so clearly loved and respected by many. And they can all trust their nation is with them in this time of sorrow. When we reflect on Ratu Tevita's life, we remember a devoted educator who cared deeply for the success of his students. We remember him as an ambassador. We remember a strong leader with a good heart and a relentless focus on the well-being of his people. We are grateful for his 14 years of service as part of the Itoke Land Trust Board, as well as his time as chairman of the Bar Provincial Council, positions he held up until his passing. Even in his final days, he gave all he could to his communities and his country. The quality of Itoke Saweke's leadership is seen through his legacy within the institutions he helped to run. During his time at the TLTB, he helped us secure the equal distribution of lease money to all landowners, establish the present structure for land development, and raise awareness among young people to encourage a culture of saving. You will all have read the savings that our under 18 have in the TLTB. He possessed an ability that few leaders hold to perceive the future and prepare his fellow Fijians for both challenges and opportunities on the horizon. Now that he has found final rest from his labors, those deeds will follow him. Indeed, they have built the very foundation of equity and economic empowerment for land-owning communities across our nation. History will remember Ratu Tevita for all these reasons. But I believe, above all, he will be remembered for how he chose to respond to some of our nation's most challenging chapters. This year, the year 2000 was one of the toughest Fiji has ever known. Our nation was mired in political turmoil and marked by deadly violence. Amid that crisis and confusion, the nation urgently called on Ratu Tevita Momoedonu to serve his country unselfishly. The former president, His Excellency Ratu Josefa Uluimunda, Ratu Josefa Uluimunda, appointed him as Prime Minister twice, in May of 2000 and March of 2001, to assist with the transition of the government. Both times, he answered the call, not in the selfish pursuit of higher office, but for the simple reason that he felt his nation needed him. He was indeed the man that moment in history demanded. A man of peace, a man who possessed the unselfish willingness to stand aside to allow for a peaceful nation, peaceful transition of power in the nation, a man who, above all, put Fiji first. In those defining tests of his principles, in every day of his life, and throughout all of his work, Ratu Tevita's patriotism was apparent. The legacy he built is larger than the proud family he leaves behind. The legacy he built is larger than the Bonoa Gunda he knew as home. It is larger than the province of Mba he proudly served. Indeed, it extends across all of Fiji. every Fijian owes the nation they know today to the history that Tevita helped to write. On behalf of a grateful nation, I thank the Turkish Voreqe for his service and the noble example he has set for all of us. I have heard the word, the term affectionate addressed in one of a former speaker, and he is a perfectionist. He is a perfectionist in the way he administers himself, administers the way he dresses himself, the way he speaks. The way he deals with his people. Whenever I am in his presence, I feel the aura of a man who loves his family and his Munua. I always respected Ratu Tevita Momoedonu, and I pray his good and loving soul rest well. God bless him. God bless his family, God bless the people of Gunda, and God bless Fiji. Nagole.
Thank you.